Hello, I'm Calm Cal. Welcome to the channel.
In this episode, we're going to have a look at some software called Sneses, which is a front end which helps us emulate the SNES. The download for this is available on sneses.com. It has been developed by the same people, Tripwire, that brought us Blast 16. This is the Twitter page where they post updates, and also you can find links for Sneses and also Blast 16. On the Sneses website itself, there's a little video here that shows you all the different menus and features, so you just click play and watch. As you scroll down, it gives you more information about the software itself, and as you look here, it does actually say that it's compatible with RetroFlag's SuperPi Case, which is what I am using, and it's automatically got the scripts for the reset and shutdown. Scroll down a little bit further and there is a donate button here. There's no cost to download, but developers like this do need support. Here's all the links for downloads, and there's also a viewing option here for the manual. So I'm just going to take a quick look. It shows here this front end has got various different cores and emulators, and these can be swapped within the menu system. Back to the website then, if you scroll down, you can see here there's a link for the SNES box art. So you just press this and it will download. We'll just scroll back up to the SD card image, and we'll press this button here to download the SD card image itself. These will both appear in our downloads folder, and will take a couple of minutes to download. So here in our downloads folder we've got both files, so we're going to use 7-zip and just extract here. If you haven't got 7-zip installed, have a look at this video here. There's various bits of software that are very, very useful, including Etcher, which is the next bit of software we're going to be using soon. A box art file has already been created with the first extract, so when you extract the second file, just select yes to all. So any files will just be overwritten rather than creating duplicates. And here are all the box arts in this named box arts folder. This Sneses underscore release dash one image file is the one that we want to copy to the SD card. And for this we're going to be using Berliner Etcher again. Just going to open Etcher. Select the image, select the destination drive, and then select flash. I say again because we've already used this software using Blast 16. So if you're unsure, just watch all the videos that I've made for the Blast 16 software, and it goes into more detail. This will take roughly about 5 or 10 minutes, depending on how quick your computer is and what the quality is of the SD card that you've selected to use. They are not all made the same. Make sure you select a Class 10 SD card. An 8GB card will be big enough, but the 16 and 32 are very close in price. I am going to leave affiliate links in the description of this video for this video and also the previous videos that I've made for Blast 16. Make sure you pick a quality power supply lead to avoid having this lightning bolt symbol on screen, which means it's underpowered, which will affect the performance of your Raspberry Pi. Etcher alerts you to when the flash is complete, and you may get this error message from Windows regarding formatting the disk. Just select cancel on here and eject the USB drive, and then install your SD card into your Raspberry Pi. On the first boot, you may get an error message like this. If you do, just turn your Raspberry Pi off and then back on again. That is the IT way after all. On the second boot, you may get an error message like this, but just ignore it. Sneses will load in a second. And listen to that lovely music. Something's not quite right here though. Super Famicom? We'll have to change this in the menu and change this to the SNES. This is just a front end, so there's no games included. So we will have to put our own on there, and we'll just go through how to do that now. I'm just going to shut down here from the menu. Make sure that you do shut down correctly, otherwise you might corrupt the SD card. Right, for the games, we'll have a look at the manual. You'll see that the file system is very similar to Blast 16. I am going to use a USB stick to put these games on. I'm not going to go over the network because that's a little bit complicated for some users. And this software is just for the Super Nintendo. If you feel I run through this too quickly, refer to my other videos with Blast 16. I do go into more detail explaining the file structure in those videos. On the USB drive then, I'm just going to create a folder called games, and this is all in lowercase. And then press enter, and now I'm going to double click on this folder to go inside it, then select new folder, and then create another folder called box arts, all in lowercase. So here on the left we've got the USB stick with the folder called games, and I've put a copy of the games on the desktop. So I'm just going to open the folder where all the box arts are in the downloads folder, and then we're going to find the correct box art and then just put them onto the USB stick in this window that's already open. To do this, all we do is right click on the mouse, select copy, then click on the window for the USB drive, right click on there, and then select paste. And do this for each one of the games that you've got. We'll just close the box art window, put the mouse pointer by the games that we've got on the desktop, left click and hold, and then the expanding window will cover the files as you move the pointer across them. Then release the button, and then now they're all highlighted, you just press the left button again on top of the files, and then just drag them across to the window, and then release the button. A copy of all of these will then be put inside this window. Just going to make the window a bit bigger so we can see all the files, and then we'll go through naming them. The box arts have got to match the names of the games files exactly, except for the extension at the end. The games are zip files and the box arts are PNG files. I'll start with Contra 3. What I want to do is take out this USA in brackets out. So all I'm going to do is press F2 to rename the file, and then delete the USA, and then press enter. I am then going to press F2 again so it highlights the Contra 3 dash the Alien Wars, and then if I press Ctrl and C, this will copy that part of the file, not the zip at the end, just the name of the file. And then I'm going to select the Contra 3 box art with a left click on the mouse to highlight it. Then I'm going to press F2 so it highlights the rename part of the file, not the PNG at the end. And then I'm going to press Ctrl and V to paste. Do this for all of the files. Just remember, you are holding down Ctrl when you select C or V to paste. Once done, drag them into the games folder. Do the same for the rest of the files that are in here. Double click on the games folder to go into this. So now all of the games and the box art are within the games folder. And then drag and drop all of the box arts within the box arts folder. So now we've got all the games within the games folder and all the box arts within the box arts folder. Now we can close this window and eject the USB stick. Then put the USB stick into the Raspberry Pi and then turn on the games console again. When you first boot up, the files will be transferred to your Raspberry Pi. Once booted into the menu, you can then remove your USB stick. And now we're all ready to go. The menu system is very similar to Blast 16. And as I said earlier, there is a video on the website if you want to watch that of how to navigate the menu system. Or you can watch my videos from the Blast 16 series. You have to remember, this is emulation, and games like Super Ghouls and Ghost does suffer from slowdown. This is down to some problems with emulation and certain games, but most will run fine and at full speed. You can see this while I get my arse handed to me in Street Fighter 2. You can also see the speed in Contra 3 as well. Man, this game's rapid. Overall then, Blast 16 is a great front end, and so is Sneses. Show your appreciation to the creator. Links for all of these builds will be in the video description. These are affiliate links, so please use them, and this will help me out. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share these videos. My name is Cal. Have a good morning, afternoon, or good evening. Farewell till next time, and I will see you later. Thanks for watching.